band a little bit over 14 years ago, and back then we were big fans of bands like Entombed, the Left Hand Path album, you know. Dismember, Like an Ever-Flowing Stream, Soulside Journey from Dethroned. So our first demo tape sounded basically, you know, the same like those bands, and it was not very common for a band from Holland. But anyway, we got a record deal quite fast after the demo. So already in 92, like 2 years after the start of the band, we had our first CD out called The Christ Hunt. And unfortunately, we had quite some lineup changes back then, and so things weren't going as smooth as we hoped it would go. So by early 94, I decided to put the band on ice and did some other things in the meantime. And like early 96, I decided to get the band back together with new band members, that is. And you know, we didn't have a record deal back then, so a friend of mine who owns a studio, he offered for us to record an album in his studio just for free. And so I got myself a band back together and started composing and writing songs. And I think by the second half of 96, we started recording first album for Metal Blade Records called The Grand Grimoire. It was finished like early 97. We sent out some demo tapes to record labels, and so it was Metal Blade who decided to sign us. And in October 97, The Grand Grimoire was released. Had the same lineup for like 7 years, 7-8 years since then. The drummer from the lineup from 96 left the band in 2000, and it was quite hard for us to find a new drummer. We recorded the Ravenous album with Tony Laureano on drums, the drummer from Nile, and he couldn't stay in the band, of course, because he was very busy with Nile. So we asked Janne from The Crown to do a European tour with us, and then I guess a month later a guy called Arjen sent in a CD from his band where he played in at that time, and it sounded pretty good. So we had audition and we invited some more drummers, and but Arjen was by far the best. So since then we had a new drummer. With him we recorded the Into the Lungs of Hell album. And yes, things looked good for a while at least. And in October 2004, Beef decided to leave the band, and he announced it right before our European tour with Exodus, which was not really a very nice timing. But anyway, we did the tour, he left the band, and nothing really happened for a while. And then I guess like early June this year, 2004, we parted ways with Jens, our lead guitar player. And So we wanted to record a new album, and we didn't have a band anymore, so yeah, we could have done it with the two of us, just Arjen and me. But we decided to find some new band members, and we didn't have any auditions for a bass player. I just knew Hank very well since years. He's a very nice guy, he played bass guitar, so I said, do you want to play in a band? So he came and I learned him some songs, and it turned out very well. So that was it, it was very, very easy. Then we decided to record the new album, The Lair of the White Worm, just with the three of us. I would do all the guitar parts and shit like that. But then, like I guess 2 weeks before we went into the studio, I realized that the level of playing on the new album was much, much higher than on the last one, Into the Lungs of Hell. So I thought it was a good idea to just try to find another guitar player, just to help me out. So we had auditioned with two guys, and this time it was Isaac De La Haye who proved to be the best one, the better one. And yeah, he came on audition, just he learned the three songs that I wanted him to play. And we sent the guys also a demo CD with the songs for the new album on it. And he already could play one of the songs of that album, of the demo. So we decided to choose him, and the same evening we studied another three songs. So in one night we learned like four songs. The second day of rehearsing, another three, and the last day, two songs. So he knew all the nine songs for the album in just 3 days, which was excellent in my opinion. And yeah, it was a good choice to take him in the band because he's an excellent guitar player, and we increased the amount of guitar solos on the album from like 5 on the last one to like 17 on the new album. Very diverse stuff, very, very melodic, very, very good. So really happy with that choice.
Rusty nails through your hands! Rusty nails through your soul! Rusty nails, sparks in your flesh! Rusty nails, blood in your eyes!
Band who work with a very spontaneous way of recording and composing. We just write the songs of the album in just a couple of weeks. Of course, we save some ideas, you know, all through the time from rehearsals or just composing at home. And yeah, we basically write a whole album in like a month, 5 weeks. And so Our stuff always sounds very spontaneous, at least for us, and it's for me a very good way of working. And when we go into the studio, you know, a guy like Arjen is just recording his drums in a day or a day and a half, and it gives us plenty of time to freak around on guitars and bass and vocals and stuff like that. And also recording rhythm guitars is done in like 4 or 5 days, bass guitar 1 or 2 days. So, and then to finish off the songs with the melodics, the melodies, the guitar leads, the vocals, we have then like a week, you know. And because things are never really finished when we go into the studio. It's like the basics of the song, of the songs are ready. We go into the studio, record it, and then work on the rest. So it's, even for us, a big surprise what comes out of it, you know, after 2 weeks of recording. And then we have 1 week left to do the mix, and that's basically enough for us. It's not that, it's not like 3 weeks is like more than enough or something. It's like working very long days, 7 days a week, 10 hours a day. But, you know, that's how we work, and it's just fine for us.
Okay.
Yeah.
I think this is a pretty sick song. To Brno studio in Sweden because I heard a Vomitory album. It was produced by Henrik Larsson. It sounded so fucking brutal and good that I wanted the same sound for my band. So for the Into the Lungs of Hell album, we decided to go there, and the results were very good. So we decided to go there again for the Lair of the White Worm, and I guess and they did a very good job again. And this time around, the album is much more extreme, actually in two ways. It's more melodic on one hand, but more melodic than we ever did, especially because of Isaac's leads and stuff. And on the other hand, it's more brutal. It's more, it's faster and more extreme than the other albums, apart from the Christend album, because to make an album that's more extreme than the Christend is just impossible. But apart from that, it's our most extreme album, I guess. And still, at the same time, easy listening. So that's a good thing in my opinion.
Thank you.
the lair of the White Worm.